Hi, my name's Ken. We're here from Mid-Atlantic Wrestling Insider. This here is 14-year ring veteran Jason Creation, and we're here to bring you all the news on the Carolina and Mid-Atlantic independent wrestling news, as well as some stuff from the major federations. Creation, how are you doing today?
I'm doing well. I'm excited to get the second half of my career kicked off in the independent circuit.
Good. Good to have you. We're excited, and I think we're going to really branch out into some good ideas and some good concepts for wrestling fans, and bring you some positive news on what's going on different federations and promotions across the area. Couple of newsworthy things right off the bat that have happened in recent times are the change of titles in a couple of promotions the last month or so. What's the first order of business that we have?
Well, we have the NWA Worldwide Wrestling Heavyweight Championship title, which changed. The Predator Bam actually defeated Lou Mahoney.
And that was the rebirth of Starrcade as well. Pretty exciting for old school Mid-Atlantic NWA fans. And then we have somebody that you've worked with as well as I have as a promoter, and we have JoJo Dancer, who is the Shockwave Junior Heavyweight Champion. I talked to JoJo today. He's very excited and wanted to thank everybody who has helped him along the way to get where he is. He's looking forward to moving forward in 2014 and to furthering his career. There's been a lot of talk of JoJo over the last month or so. He's been involved in a couple of different matches. Some sort of a scandalous shoot angle at one point, and then as well as just a raw talent who's really has really blossomed into something that people are excited to see.
Yeah, a lot of these young guys are phenomenal, and as coming up through the business, I don't think a lot of them realize how tough it's going to be on them. Some of them have families, they have children, they have jobs, they have to put the wrestling and their family lives all together and try to consolidate everything at one time. And it's very rough. I know how it affected my life coming up through the business.
Yeah, I think a lot of the guys coming into the business don't realize how much it takes to balance everything. And there's a lot of these delusions of grandeur that they're just going to jump right into the show. And unfortunately, I think it's one of the problems with the smaller events, and it's one of the problems with trying to find qualified people to run shows. And that's when you start, it's one of the reasons that you start seeing scorned fans. But
I agree.
But it starts at the top, and it starts with the promoters, and they have to take care of their own backyard as well.
Yes, especially in the back.
We
get a little out of hand. That's just the nature of the beast. Now on the major federations, such as World Wrestling Entertainment, they just released that a major star will be returning, Batista, here in the near future. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, I think this part-time legend contract kind of participant is the way WWE is going. I think it's a kind of a residue from not having competition, really. They're not competing with anybody, so there's no big moves to make. You're not pulling anybody out of a competitor's federation. They refused to use anybody from TNA. AJ Styles was just released, and they didn't even give him a sniff. So I think to spark interest in the product, they have to pull guys back. And if that's the way they're going to, get a boost in interest, I think it's the way to go. We're going to talk in a little bit about, during one of our segments called If I Was Creative, we're going to talk about how they could possibly use Batista down the road. Another news from major federations, I'm actually more excited about the Ring of Honor's next show in Nashville on Saturday, January 4th. They not only have Chris Hero coming in to their first TV taping of the year, they have Chris Hero, who was just released by NXT from the WWE. He was supposed to be somewhat of a prodigy, a superstar in the making, but WWE wasn't enamored with his body type as So that was the case very often with WWE. But they also bring back the phenomenal one, AJ Styles. The aforementioned AJ Styles is returning to Ring of Honor, where he had some of his best matches as a younger performer. And not only are those two returning to that show, but they are also going to be having the Ring of Honor debut of the Rowdy One, Roddy Piper, on January 4th in Nashville, I believe at the Fairgrounds. It's a big show, and I just needed wanted to put it out there to you, maybe we can discuss a little bit. Does this show, I thought previously that when Ring of Honor got their TV contract about a year and a half ago, that that was going to put them on a competitive edge with TNA, and now I'm at the point where I have to think, this show, is this the turning point of this show? Everybody pointed to the TNA show when Hogan debuted back in 2010, 2011, and now I feel like this show quite possibly could have that turning point feel for Ring of Honor, where they turn the corner and start competing with quite possibly TNA and maybe take that second force seed and maybe start thinking in a grander scale. Do you think that this show could quite possibly have a turning point for them to become a bigger promotion than they are?
Yeah, I believe Ring of Honor could potentially compete with TNA. Right now, TNA, the storylines, the angles are not, in my point of view, they are not where they need to be. Me personally, I don't see them competing anytime soon with the World Wrestling Federation. You know, Ring of Honor has a lot of good young talent. They have a lot of upcoming stars that I really enjoy watching. Not just the look, but the work rate also. What are your second thoughts on that, Ken?
Well, you're just dating yourself. It's World Wrestling Entertainment. And as well, I don't think anybody's ever going to compete with the World Wrestling Entertainment at this point. But I'm excited about what Ring of Honor could do, and potentially, you know, maybe see them as get quite possibly get as big as ECW was at one point. I'm curious to see how Roddy Piper's relationship with Ring of Honor grows. When I see pictures of his son, he reminds me of somebody that Ring of Honor might be interested in, that compact athletic build. And I know he's been wrestling over in the Pacific Coast in Roddy's independent promotion for a while now. And I'm wondering if this is a segue to get Piper's son in the door.
It possibly could be. I think Piper is going to bring an entertainment aspect to Ring of Honor. It's going to help him turn the corner, if you know what I mean.
He's been doing almost a traveling show of his Piper's Pit. He's done it at Vanguard Wrestling out of Norfolk. He's Norfolk, Virginia. He's done a Piper's Pit or two on TNA, where I think he had a reunion with Snuka back at the early stages of TNA. And, you know, speaking of TNA, actually, we're missing some big news as well, as Jeff Jarrett of TNA resigned via Twitter this week, and there were some rumors about maybe you might hear his music at the Royal Rumble. I don't think Vince McMahon and Jeff Jarrett will ever have a reuniting moment. I think there's some bad blood there.
Yeah, I agree. Some bad blood, definitely. They definitely have a long future in that.
Vince McMahon is fine, I think, with people and their history until you try to take money out of his pocket. And then it's personal forever. And what you were saying about TNA and storylines, I think until Dixie Carter removes herself from storylines, that promotion is going to spiral downward. She is not a great element for storylines. Her on-camera presence is brutal at the very least.
Yeah, Dixie Carter, she is definitely not a favorite of mine. I'm not sure how the fans feel about her. I hope we can get some positive feedback on some of these topics after the show.
Our next segment, If I Was Creative, is going to be brought to you by your Wassa Wassa sponsors. Like I mentioned before, our next segment, If I Was Creative, we're going to be talking about what the possible storylines you could use for Batista in the WWE if you were in charge of creative, if you were a writer or in creative. Creation, you said you had some ideas. What would be your first ideas for that?
I would think maybe he has a history there with Brock Lesnar, guys such as The Undertaker. You could maybe bring him back for WrestleMania, Batista versus Undertaker, Batista versus Brock Lesnar. Or you have that whole evolution spiel where it was Orton, Batista, Triple H, and Flair, Orton being the champion, Batista coming in as, top tier talent to challenge the champion. That would be something new and different that we hadn't seen over the last 5 or 6 months.
Well, my thing that I would do would be I would have Orton and Triple H and Stephanie and the corporation, whatever they're calling themselves, whatever rendition of the corporation they're having, call them out, introduce them, and welcome them back to the legacy reunion. And then I would have Batista, sucker Orton into one of his finishers and then challenge him for a title match at the Royal Rumble. That way you can get two main events or two main event quality matches out of them at two different pay-per-views. The one versus Orton and then whoever he wrestles at the WrestleMania.
Now in your mind, who gets the bigger push there? Do they push Orton or do they give Batista, the big push?
I think Orton retains the title. I don't know where the push goes because I think as a heel champion, you could very often end up with a Ric Flair weak title defense victory, especially with outside interference, and where the challenger remains strong, but the champion retains the title. Does that make sense to you?
Right, that makes sense to me. I mean, well, that's like they have Daniel Bryan on the card. I don't know how a lot of people feel about Daniel. I think he's phenomenal at what he does. I'm looking forward to him maybe winning a title at WrestleMania.
It would be exciting to have that happen. He certainly is the most exciting guy in the promotion at this point. When he starts doing that Tasmanian devil thing where he just goes from pillar to post and hitting everybody with knees and elbows and drop kicks. It's a frenzy, and I don't think the fans react to it. And I think that's part of the deal. When you can get the fans reacting to every little thing, it makes the live events so much better.
Well, I agree 100%, and I'm definitely looking forward to 2014 in the professional wrestling world.
We just want to thank everybody for tuning in. We have another segment called Heel Turn, where we're going to start doing editorials. The show's a work in progress, so we're going to come up with more segments. We're going to try and keep everything positive, but I think we both have some things that we want to talk about at times. So the Heel Turn is maybe the segment where we get a little rough around the edges. We're looking forward to expressing some of our interests in the heel turn segment, which is going to be an editorial where we both discuss things and maybe even have point and counterpoint during that where we maybe don't agree on things. This has been the first show, so we're just knocking the bugs out, and we've been in agreement a lot today, but I think there's going to be points where we start discussing things that we maybe have different point of views on. Our show is going to be airing at 7 o'clock on the Wassa Wassa channel on Ustream.
I'm excited about the show, and I just can't wait to kick it off and get everything going in the right direction.
Yeah, and we're excited about bringing guests in and doing interviews and doing on-site interviews.
Definitely, JoJo, that's the way he likes to pump the fist and dance around.
Maybe we even have JoJo, maybe we can even have you and JoJo get the ring and show us some finer points. We're here, we got the ring, we got two of Carolina's best at our disposal.
So we can definitely do that. We can definitely put that in and market it up for a future day.
Great. Everybody, I hope you guys have a happy new year. And again, 7 o'clock, Wassa Wassa Ustream channel. Happy new year, happy new year, and enjoy the shows.